Morenci is a remote place right now. I mean, anybody who's been there, there's not a lot of cities around there. It's rough. And you can think about what it would have been like to venture into that country in the late 1800s. No infrastructure, no power. There was a river, but not really any water resources. Do you think of what had to be in place to make that successful? And it went to the perseverance and the vision and just the drive of the prospectors, the mine owners, and the risk takers that made that happen.
It is a place of legend and lore, prospectors and pioneers, a place with deep roots.
So my dad came up here in 27. My dad worked in the power, the diesel plant. My mother went to work in the mill during the war effort. She started as a laborer and worked up through the flotation, ball mill operator. And my sister was the first female secretary that worked in the Morenci open pit. My brother and I both worked there. He was a sheet metal man and I was a boilermaker. My daughter was a summer student, so our whole family got involved in the mining business over the years. I worked for the company for 45 years. I went to work right out of high school, which I graduated from Clifton.
From Morenci, Arizona, where the copper mines glow, I could see Clifton and the canyon below. In Clifton lived Rosie, we danced and we dined on the money I made in the open pit mine.
For generations, the people of Morenci have built this place in the eastern Arizona desert mountains to become much more than a mine. Over the course of nearly 150 years, Morenci has stood at the leading edge of an industry that helped to build a nation, providing the copper that fuels today's global economy. The Morenci story is one with many colorful chapters already recorded and a new and exciting growth story now underway. At a time when new copper discoveries are rare and historic mines are seeing reserves dwindle, the world-class Morenci deposit has found new life.
It's by far one of the largest porphyry copper systems in the world. It's certainly one of the largest in North America, if not the largest. A lot of things have to go into place to make a district like Morenci successful. You need the exploration, you need the good observation skills that go with that, you need mine planning to make it a profitable mining way to do it, but you need the right processing streams, but you need the management and the productive workforce to make all of this happen. And I think that's been in place at Morenci, where we've been mining there since 1872. The view of it was dim by some, but as exploration has indicated, the future is very bright. And I think we're on the cusp of a very exciting future for a district that is large, very significant, but could be a huge foundation for Freeport as we go forward.
Through the years, the people of Morenci have adjusted to the winds of economic change. A century ago, prospectors found high-grade copper in abundance.
The ore grades were phenomenal at that point in time, 15% copper content. They just took the rock directly out of the ground and smelted it.
When the easy pickings were mined out, they dug deeper, going underground to find more. As mineral grades dropped, the spirit of innovation prevailed. A new technology made mining more efficient. Burrows were traded for rail cars, picks and shovels replaced by huge mechanical equipment. In more recent history, Morenci discovered ore types that would require new methods, and the people of Morenci led the way in advancing technology. The operation survived historic low commodity prices by moving towards leaching techniques that made it possible to extract more copper from low-grade ore.
So in the late 1990s, as copper prices started to drop, at that point in time, Morenci looked at our reserves that we had in front of us, what our economics were, and the decision was made to shut all of our milling operations down and go to a pure 100% leaching operation. And in the early 2000s, we built what we call Mine for Leach and started crushing and stacking our leach material. And that gave Morenci a new life, if you will, at that point in time and allowed us to survive the low copper prices of the early 2000s. As copper prices started to come back, we were able to then reevaluate our reserves and what made the most economic sense.
Geologists, armed with more than a hunch, suggested that large resources of millable ore were laying in wait beneath the proven reserves. And they had been waiting for an opportunity to prove their case.
During the course of exploration, I started working at Morenci in 91, and we worked on aspects of the district. And during that time, the focus of the exploration was to identify leachable mineralogy. Part of geological processes of how those formed is they are converted from what was a very large sulfide mass. Well, that still existed at depth. But with so much emphasis towards leaching, the recognition of a huge sulfide mass was present, but for various reasons, we never really got the budget in an exploration sense to do the drilling. And so with Freeport's view of exploration, it was significant at Morenci because they provided the vision and the funding which enabled us to do the drilling, which has resulted in what we see as an immense resource of millable material situated, again, beneath some of the older stuff that was mined by leaching.
You know, as our chairman, Jim Bob Moffat, says, exploration drives a mine plan, and that's certainly been the case at Morenci. We've been very successful with the drilling program there over the last 7 years. We've added 8 billion pounds of recoverable copper to the reserve. That's really the beginning of the opportunity. So from there, again, very clearly stated Freeport objectives. We have a strong belief in the future of copper and the need for copper in today's world, and the way we create value for our shareholders is to bring those mineral reserves that we've discovered forward in time by expanding the metal volume production and then enjoying the cash flows that come with that for the benefit of our investors and everybody involved with the company. So that's really at the heart of this Morenci expansion story.
The new ore would require additional milling capacity. Permits for a mill expansion would normally require much time. This time, it would move quickly.
Well, this is a really fast-track project. It started with not a lot of engineering, and so we had to go into it. We went into it fast, and we went into it strong. And we didn't. And we needed resources from everywhere. The Americas jumped in a big way. We gathered the best talent from around our mining company, and between the Americas and the mining company and the rest of the technical resources within the Freeport organization, we put together a great team. But it took a superhuman effort because it was a fast track job. It really required some innovative thinking and a lot of extra effort.
We had actually had the property permitted to treat 125,000 tons a day of ore through concentrators. At the time that we were looking at this expansion, we were only treating 55,000 tons a day. So to add back 75,000 tons a day and go back to those historic rates was relatively straightforward to permit because we had done it before. We had a lot of the infrastructure already in place for tailings and those kinds of things. So, and you know, just a very capable, well-trained workforce there at Morenci's.
The decision to expand was embraced by the people of Morenci, no strangers to challenge. It would provide several thousand construction jobs and an unwavering commitment to safety.
We've got a great safety culture throughout Freeport-McMoRan, and that is prevalent at Morenci as well. The two cornerstones of our safety ethic are fatality prevention and personal accountability. And, you know, by consistently working those two priorities as hard as all of us are able to, we have been very successful completing this particular project with no fatalities and a very commendable reportable injury rate. And those then help you with finishing the project in a timely manner, achieving your cost expenditure objectives. All of those things fit really well together. And of course, the most important thing being that all of our employees and contractors go home at the end of the day the same way they came in the gate. And just to take a few minutes and talk about the spirit of our people at Morenci, they have a real can-do attitude. There's no challenge we can't overcome. There's nothing that we can't fix. And that has, you know, really served us well over the years. As you can imagine, we faced with a lot of challenges, both natural things like weather and rock slides and those kinds of things, to major changes in the copper markets that we've all had to respond to. So the people are very, very flexible and very industrious in approaching that. So you've got a great esprit de corps there.
And that spirit would motivate the team to exceed expectations.
From start to finish, really from concept of 2009 to construction and operation in 2014, probably a four and a half year time period. While that seems long, that's relatively fast given what we're facing today on an overall basis in terms of permitting, engineering, and construction.
The expansion would bring the Morenci Mine's annual copper output to more than 1 billion pounds of copper per year, making it one of the highest producing copper mines in the world.
Over the life of the project, it's an incremental expansion of 225 million pounds a year over the life of the reserves that Morenci has. So that'll be from now until 2030. The first 5 years of the project, it'll be significantly more than that. As we go forward, get the mill up and running at 100% basis, we'll be producing 1.1 billion pounds. For the life of the project, our incremental expansion is 225 million pounds a year through the sulfide circuit.
The centerpiece of the expansion is the Metcalf Mill, an existing building that had been shuttered since the late 1990s.
That building was sitting there for the last 10, 15 years. And as we looked at conceptually what makes sense to build a new milling operation, we said, well, let's go look and see if it makes sense to utilize the old infrastructure. And as such, we took advantage of some of those facilities and are utilizing the shell of the building. But at the end of the day, we were able to utilize an old mill building to house the new mill.
We looked at those facilities and we said, here's a big opportunity to cut down on our capital costs. It's a large structure. It's, steel is very expensive nowadays. Construction costs, installation costs are expensive. So we decided, and after review, that we could essentially take the inside of the building apart and leave all the superstructure around there and completely reuse the building. And so, we added a HRC building, and we added a ball mill building, but we used the main Metcalf building, which I think saved us a lot of money.
the expansion project in and of itself included what we call the Morenci Canyon, which is our crushing and conveying portion of it. So we have the material coming from the mine. After it goes through the primary crushing, it goes in and it gets screened and crushed through our secondary crushers. And then we have a long series of conveyors that bring it from the Morenci Canyon area over to the Metcalf building. We're using the old bins that were from the old Metcalf mill. That material is placed in there. And then that material is fed into what's called the HRC, or the hydraulic roll crusher, which was developed in conjunction with Metso. And that becomes our tertiary crusher. And that's outside of the Metcalf building. The product of the HRC then goes in and feeds the ball mills. The ball mills are also outside of the old building just because they wouldn't fit on the inside. And then the product of the ball mills gets fed into the flotation circuit, which is all inside, housed in the old Metcalf building.
This job involves some very energy efficient equipment, starting with a roll crusher the biggest in the world, followed by some what we call high efficiency ball mills. They're larger ball mills with lots of power, but you can run them fast or slow depending on production or energy needs. Those two in particular really are going to set the stage for the way that we do business going forward, and likely will change the way that the industry does their business. If they're as good as we think they are, and could be as much as 25% more energy efficient than some of the other grinding circuits in the world, that's a huge benefit for us. I think it'll revolutionize the industry.
So the project also entailed upgrading some of our tailings thickeners, upgrading concentrate thickeners, as well as additional tailings pump station, and ultimately we will have a new tailings storage facility as well.
And the expansion would not end at the gates of the operations. An entire community would grow along with the mine.
So one of the things that's unique about Morenci is that we have a company town, if you will, and the company town has been in place for years and years and years. But realistically, the Morenci town site hadn't had a lot of money invested in it probably in the last 20 or so years. And so as part of the project, we made a conscious decision to really focus on how do we improve the quality of life in Morenci for all of our workers that are here. And what are some things that we can do about that? As part of the overall project, we invested a significant amount of money in the town site. Includes additional road construction, improving roads. We built a new school, so we were able to add additional facilities there. We also built a new community center that has an indoor pool, something for the kids to do during the day, so to speak, a significant investment. We've done a lot of things around town in terms of parks, working on basically creating a parks and rec district, provide additional activities for folks, so it really becomes more like what most people know as a town, and so that'll allow us to improve the quality of life, but also it acts as a recruiting tool to attract, hire, and retain folks as we bring them on site.
It's been a real fun, rewarding byproduct of the expansion to add some of those kinds of things. Again, for the bright future that we have at Morenci, long life in front of us, and just a new era and a new phase in the property, of which there have been many, many eras and phases in the past, so it continues to reinvent itself and get better and better over time.
Over time, the people of Morenci have done much more than mine copper. They have led an industry, exploring, building, innovating, and creating opportunity. As new growth takes root in the Arizona desert, the Morenci spirit prevails.
Morenci is a special one. It's a mine that was discovered over 140 years ago, actually by members of the U.S. Cavalry, Jim and Bob Metcalf. Over the years, it has been the flagship mine in the copper mining industry in the United States. And today, with our recent expansion, it has returned to its place as one of the world's greatest producers of copper. It's gratifying to see what our team has done there. Our operating team at site, our development team, and supported by our world-class financial, administrative, legal, and marketing teams, have truly made this a keystone asset of our company. We started a project to expand our copper production by 25% in 2010. With our expansion of the Tenke-Fungurume mine in the Democratic Republic of Congo, now Morenci, and with our progress for an expansion at Cerro Verde in Peru, we will achieve that goal by 2016 of increasing our copper production by 25%. And this is not the end. There's tremendous resources yet to be developed at Morenci, at our other mines in the United States, and globally around the world. You know, the world's going to need the resources that we produce: copper, molybdenum, cobalt, oil and gas, and we look forward to a bright future of our company in fulfilling the world's demands for these commodities. We have a great team of people here at Freeport-McMoRan. We've got a great set of assets, and we're going to do great things for our shareholders and for the communities where we operate.